Mertz Schaffer here with another Big Brother Canada interview. I am here with this season's third place finisher, Tara. Let's get right into it. How does it feel to be here today?
I wish I had some money while I was sitting here, but it still feels great. It was an amazing, amazing ride.
You decided to eliminate Kiefer over Brayden. Do you regret that decision, knowing how closely connected Ty and Brayden were?
Honestly, no. It really came down to, if I didn't win, who would I want to see take it? And I loved me some Brayden. I was a Brayden fan right until the end. I was an oddball till the end. And honestly, I felt Kiefer did me so dirty with that fake double eviction. He was not safe with me. No, not after that.
How did Kiefer do you dirty? Can you go into more detail?
Well, in that double eviction, so we had gotten out Jed with the trap door, mm-hmm. and we had Kiefer and I, like, I told him, I was like, I am ready. Like, let's go to war. These people have not been good to you. I will be good to you. Mm-hmm. And it was like, we got out Jed. We did this amazing plan. And then he voted me out, like, right after. Like, he didn't, you know, I was sitting on the block next to Beth, and he took the shot at me. And at that point with Kiefer, it was more personal because I told him, I'm ready to go to war with you. I told him, and he voted me out. So I had to return the favor.
Speaking of duos, you had a close connection with Tina. Do you think that your close friendship with her prevented you from making bonds with the others? Near the end of the game, it seemed like everyone had closer relationships with each other than they did with you.
Absolutely. You know, especially when you're in a duo, it does kind of isolate you. I wouldn't change it for the world. Tina is, you know, she's going to be one of my best friends leaving this house. She was such a rock, such a support system. But for sure, you know, it is hard to get in with different groups, especially at the age that I am. You know, it was hard to really get in there and connect on different levels because I'm in a completely different stage of life.
Your argument with Spicy V, where all of the alliances were revealed, was one of the most epic. Can you take me back to that moment and how you were feeling when everything was sort of being aired out?
It was a wild moment for sure. And honestly, I felt terrible, you know, to feel like people think that you don't deserve to be somewhere, feeling that you constantly have to prove your worth. It was very, very hard. And to constantly be told that I was, you know, like this liar manipulator when I was actually trying to play a pretty clean game. Everybody knew where my head was at. I wasn't some of those things. So it was hard. It was hard for sure.
During the ball pit contest, you also called everyone out for not wanting to eliminate Jed, which seemed to be your singular goal. This got Kiefer particularly fired up. How satisfying was it then to be able to knock both Jed and Kiefer out later in the game?
It was amazing. Honestly, I do actually love both those guys, but their egos were huge. There were so many times where they said it was going to come down to Kiefer and Jed in the end and who would win. And I was sick and tired of hearing about it. So they had to go.
Did Kiefer have a big ego?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes, Kiefer had a huge ego in the house. He would tell people, like, even right up until, like, I cut him, he went through his speech with me and his jury vote and how he was going to win. He told me that I would only get $20,000. You know, like, he's like, you're making a $20,000 mistake right mm-hmm. now. And it was like, no, I think Canada would be surprised. Kiefer had a huge ego in the house.
Was Kiefer the sole player responsible for Operation Trapdoor and getting Jed to use the veto on Beth? Or were you and Ty also involved?
No way. I will give him credit that it was his crazy idea. But me and Ty had to execute it. And Brayden had to play a role as well. Kiefer came up with the idea, but he didn't do anything other than come up with the idea. You know, we had to convince it. We had to sell it. We had to pull it off. So for him to take credit for that entire move was audacious.
Clearly, for sure, like, you had a focus on getting, Jed out of the game. Do you believe that you were too focused on Jed and didn't see the threat that Ty posed to your game?
Yes and no. my focus, I knew they were both huge competitors, but I actually knew that Jed was loyal to the soil. I knew that Ty would crack, he would crumble. I knew that he would snake people. So it just became a matter of who's going to get out who. Am I going to be able to get out Ty, or is he going to get out me? I knew Jed had to go because he was the most loyal person in that house. That's true. And he wasn't loyal to me. So he had to go.
And we're almost done here. Despite you and Jed butting heads in the game, he consoled you after you were initially evicted. Can you take me back to that moment and what you both told each other before returning to the game?
Honestly, that moment that I had with Jed was one of my most beautiful moments in the house. I think we finally started to see each other as people and how similar we were. And to this, like, there is, I would never say a bad thing about Jed. I have so much respect for him. I think he is, you know, he lives with his heart and he is loyal. And I think those are beautiful qualities. And it was crazy, but when I sent him packing, I was really sad to see him go. I wish I would have worked with him sooner.
If you had won the final HOH, who would you have taken to the end?
I was for sure taking Brayden. I wanted two oddballs at the end. That's why I took Brayden in like over Kiefer. I really wanted an underdog to win this story. I still can't believe I was the only one that voted for him, but I love an underdog and I wanted an underdog to win no matter what.
Do you think you could have beaten Ty in the final two?
In the votes, I think it really came down to who won that last comp. And honestly, my second showing, it was terrible. You know what I mean? Like I didn't earn that spot there. I got flustered. I made a very foolish mistake that cost me $100,000, but whoever won, I think was winning the game in the end. I think I would have given him a run for his money, but I think he still would have had it for sure.
And last question is, you told Tina at one point in the game that the other house guests hadn't seen your fire yet. Do you think that they, along with the rest of Canada, has seen it now? And what is the biggest thing you've learned from this experience?
I think everybody has seen the reign of Tara and you have seen my fire. I mean, to be underestimated, to have people tell you you don't deserve something, to be proving your worth. I hope that I showed everyone, don't give up on yourself. You fight until the end and you finish what you start, and even win or lose, like, I made a difference in that game. And I was part of history as well with the finale. So I held my head high right until the end.
Can you just say Sunsetters, eh? Because that was the funniest thing I've ever seen.
Oh, Sunsetters, eh?
Amazing. Tara, thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you.